Hi everyone, today I'm going to show you how you can create this abstract loop in Blender. If you're interested, then stick around until the end of the video. So let's get started. First, let's shift A and add a plane. Now go to geometry nodes and click on new. Delete the group input and add a volume cube node. Put that here and alt shift click on it. Add a volume to mesh node and put that here. Now we need a set material node. Put that here and add a join geometry node. Add a mix RGB. Plug the color into the density. Now add a gradient texture. Duplicate the mix RGB and plug the color into the factor and into color 1. Now plug this color into the factor and into color 1 again. Add a mask wave texture. Connect the height to color 2 and set it to 40. Now keyframe the W. Let's drag this up and open the graph editor. Make sure the plane and the node are selected, otherwise you won't be able to see this. Now go to the modifiers here. Add a noise modifier. Set the scale to 15 and the strength to 0.5. Enable restrict frame range. And set the end to 250. Now set the blend in and out to 10. If we press play, we've got a looping animation now. You can close this window again. Let's add a wave texture. Plug the color into color 2 here. Set the scale to 3 and the distortion to 10. I forgot to set the gradient texture to spherical. Go to the volume cube node and set the resolution to 128. Select all of these nodes here. Press Ctrl+Shift+D to duplicate them and keep the connection here. Plug the set material into the joint geometry. Add a color ramp. And let's flip it. Go here and flip color ramp. Go to the material properties and click on new. Click on the plus sign and click on new again. For this one, let's select the first material and here the second one. Now let's save. There are still two nodes that we need, so hit Shift A and add a subdivision surface node. And let's also add a set shade smooth node. I'm going to leave the subdivision surface at 1. Go to shading. I'm going to use cycles for this. Go to the world properties and under color, select sky texture. Set the sun elevation to 5 and the sun rotation to 45. It doesn't matter which material you have selected right now because you can switch them in geometry nodes anyway. For the first material, I'm going to delete the principal BSDF and add a subsurface scattering node. Ctrl Shift click on it. And for the color, I'm going to use this value here. Select the other material that we created. For this one, let's set the metallic to 1, the roughness to 0.48. Add a bump node. Plug the normal into the normal. Now add a noise texture. Plug the factor into the height and set the scale to 10. Let's set the detail to 8. Press Ctrl+T and use the object coordinate. Add a mask wave texture and plug the vector into the vector. Set the scale to 400 and the detail to 15. Let's also set the dimension to 0. Now plug the height into the base color. Add a color ramp. Put it here. For the white, I'm going to use this value. And for the black, I'm going to use this value. Let's save again and go back to layout mode. Press delete on the numpad with the plane selected and 1. Hit Shift A and add a camera. Control Alt 0 to go into camera view and press G and set twice to move it like this. Hit Shift A and add an empty plane axis. And go to the object constraint properties. select shrink wrap and select the plane. Go into side view by pressing 3 on the numpad and press G and Y and move the empty like this. As you can see, it's going to basically stick to the plane now. Go back into camera view and go up here and enable depth of field. I don't recommend that you play the animation now because we've got a lot of geometry and that will cause it to lag. But basically, if we would play the animation, the empty would follow the deformations of the geometry. Let's go back into camera view, select the camera and go to the object data properties, enable depth of field and select the empty. Set the f-stop to 0.2 and the blades to 16. Go to the render properties. I'm going to render it at 128 samples. Now go to color management, view transform and set it to filmic and set the look to very high contrast. Go to compositing, enable use nodes, add a denoise node set to accurate and enable denoising data. And then just connect it the way I did. Go to the output properties, select a resolution that you want, and let's select an output folder. I created a new folder for this. I'm going to call the images rendered images and put an underscore after the name so that Blender is going to automatically assign numbers to the frames. Now click on accept. Select a file format that you want. I'm going to use JPEG and set the quality to 100%. Press Ctrl F12 to render the animation. Now that it's done rendering, close this window and go to video editing. Hover over the file location and press Ctrl C. Set the file format to FFmpeg video. Go to encoding and set the container to MPEG-4. Set the output quality to high quality. Now here hit Shift A, image sequence. If you aren't already in the folder here, you can paste in the location now, minus the name of the images and hit enter. Press A and enter. Save again and press Ctrl F12 to render the animation. If you liked this tutorial, then you are probably also going to like the one that is on screen now. I'll see you next time.